You must understand the Federal Reserve is a cartel made up of the major banks in America. And they are the ones that are running the show, not the federal government.
The powers that be behind the system, the financial interests, are able to exercise a disproportionate amount of influence on not only the economic structure of the country, but the political structure.
This would be like the ultimate reaching of government into our personal health lives, which would be unbelievable. And not even our government, some, you know, bureaucratic, diffuse, multinational, secretive government.
Assure the American people that, one, I've got the authority to do this. America people expect us to protect them and protect their civil liberties. I'm going to do that.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help me God.
So help me God.
So help me God.
What happens if your own government is using more force and more coercion on its own citizens for the purpose of achieving its political ends? Is that government engaged in terrorism?
The government's now putting a national ID card together and they want checkpoints.
We will be carrying our papers, and they have recommended there'll be checkpoints throughout the country.
Isn't that what Nazi Germany did, that everybody in America was against? Checkpoints, papers, please? May I see your papers?
May I see your papers?
I don't think I have them on me.
In that case, we'll have to ask you to come along.
Wait, it's possible that, yes. Here we are.
These papers expired 3 weeks ago. You'll have to come along.
Halt! Halt!
In the new legislation, the national ID card is in it. It takes 3 or 4 pages to describe, and it will be connected with our driver's licenses. The states will be instructed on exactly what they have to do. Social security numbers will be used. Some type of a physical proof, such as fingerprints or retinal prints, have to be on it.
is time to wake up, America. These ID cards are not about defeating terrorism, but they are all about controlling the American people. I arranged an interview with Catherine Albrecht, a leading authority on the RFID chip. Her book entitled Spy Chips is the definitive book on this subject. I wanted to find out just how dangerous these chips are to our liberties.
RFID is a technology that uses tiny computer chips, the size of a grain of sand or even smaller, hooked up to miniature antennas to transmit information about items at a distance. Back in 1999, Procter & Gamble, Gillette, and MIT got together to find a way to commercialize this technology and make it small enough, make it efficient enough, and make it low cost enough to, essentially, their dream is to put one of these tiny computer chips on every physical item manufactured on planet Earth. The latest technology for identifying people at the point of sale, for identifying people when they make purchases, is actually the implantable chip that you can actually embed directly into human flesh. It's a tiny glass capsule about the size of a grain of rice. It contains an RFID computer chip with a coiled antenna, and it can transmit information also at a distance.
Can a microscopic tag be implanted in a person's body to track his every movement? There's actual discussion about that. You will rule on that, mark my words, before your tenure is over.
Homeland Security folks, the Department of Defense, and others have expressed an interest in being able to more closely monitor the U.S. populace. And one way to do that, of course, would be being able to determine who buys what and where they take those things.
We have a Florida family who are really pioneers in a brave new world. They have volunteered to be the first ever to have microchip identification devices implanted into their body.
After 9/11, I was really concerned with the security of my family.
I wouldn't mind having something planted permanently in my arm that would identify me.
The media controls the information that a person gets. In various ways, they can make sure that the average American watching the tube or reading the newspaper is going to come out with a certain mindset. He's going to say, this is good, that's bad, and that's all they have to do.
You look at the ownership of corporate media in this country. Who owns CBS? Viacom? Who owns NBC? GE? Who owns ABC? Disney?
Americans have been taught to expect their salvation from government instead of recognizing government as the most dangerous threat they'll face in their lives.
And the United States putting together a constitution now for Iraq. You know, why don't we just give Mars? I mean, think about it. It served us well for over 200 years, and we don't appear to be using it anymore, so what the heck?